Anybody saw the movie The Descendants? Yeah, we were lucky to get a few songs in that movie. Now all I gotta do every 3 months is walk down to P.O. Box 12804, Lahaina, 96761, and pick up my royalty check. But the most famous of the songs is made famous by Bob's Fabi Kamenu. A song about the twin waterfalls called He Love You. We're gonna feature my wife Nancy. All eyes gaze at the twin waterfall. Maka. Kumaka kahikin ya hi ilave. Fafalo hi mai ya umau kele. Kumaka. Kumaka kahikin ya hi ilave. Fafalo hi mai ya umau kele. Birds are chattering in the forest. Fakile maya tanu himanu valaune funivai pio. Fakile maya itanu himanu avalaune funivai pio. Fakile. Pakele maya tanu himanu avalaune funivai pio. Aole, aole nova eloa amai ayuhi vaya no te tuhi. Aole. Ole nova eloa amai ai uhi vai no te tua hiwi. Your precious love iva iva o e na kamakua ai lehi a ina ke kupuna ei vai. Ehi vai vau e nā kamakua, ai lehi ai nā ke kupuna. Your fragrance of puna, city by the waterfalls. No puna ke ala I alihe mai, no I ka vai lele I ahi I lave. No puna ke ala I alihe mai, no I ka vai lele hi I lave. Let the story be told. Aina ia mai, anaka puanala, kumaka kahikena, yahi I lave. For generations to come. Aina ia mai, anaka puanala, kumaka kahikena, yahi I lave. Hi I lave, hi I lave. Hello, Nancy. He loved it. But it's with great pleasure of being one of the sons of Maui. Jack Peterson, born and raised there, one of the greatest slacky players of our time. He's actually taking slacky into the future with some new tunes and new stylings and new fingers. How about a hand for Jack Peterson from the island of Maui?
But there was a song written about another part of the island, Waikiki, that was written by Andy Cummings. And he wrote it very close to here. He was on a tour about this time of year, many years ago, and just frozen and missing his home. And this very beautiful song about Waikiki and the sunny skies and the beautiful trade winds and the palm trees. A piece by Andy Cummings, and it's called Waikiki. Thank you. you. So here's a song from upcountry Maui, Wahipana, a very sacred place of the ranch. But it's a fun song, and it's called The Kukuinat Run. This time, I'd like to welcome to the stage one of the greatest slacky players who's ever played. He's such an amazing person and an inspiration to every Hawaiian musician in Hawaii, Mr. Ledward Kaapana.
Nice hand for Jeff Peterson, yeah? Great job. Awesome guitar player. I learned all my music on the Big Island of Hawaii as I was growing up. Mom, dad, uncles and aunties, grandmas, they all played music. And every Fridays and Saturdays, there was always a special day where all the family get together. And they used to play this music called Kihualo Hawaiian Slacky. Anyway, I did for you the song called Pauhana Slacky. Pauhana, which means it's all power, it's all finished. It was composed by my dad, the late John Kaapana. Thank you. Mahalo. Thank you. You know, I also was inspired by many slacky artists from Hawaii. Gabby Vainui, Uncle Sanitini's work, Leonard Kowal, Rick Kani. But I did a song that was composed by Leonard Kowal. A song that talks about the sleeping shellfish. He called this song Opi Moe Moe. Moe Moe, which means to go to sleep.
Yes, I like to say, you know, it's so awesome traveling around with George and Jeff. We really have a nice time sharing music. Anyway, this song will take you to the island of Kauai. How many of you been to the island of Kauai? Everybody, yeah? One of our the late Dennis Kamakai, he wrote so many beautiful songs for the islands. Especially this song that takes you to this special place called Koki.
Uruguay, Hemana, oh, Ikabigi, oh, Koke, Ikanani, oh, Kaina, Kano. I'm I boogie number one. Kalala, yeah, I know. Ikauba, ili. Hawaii, mela, ule, aloha. I never know to say goodbye. Never know to say goodbye.
I said, what? She doesn't want to tell me. So I reached over there, got over there, and my guitar was cracked open. I mean, I'll send you the photos later on, but it was like cracked, this big crack right on the edge. And looked like they dropped it from like 100 feet up in the sky. And usually I hand carry it, but you know, it was a choice between having the bento lunch I was eating and carrying the guitar. So I just said the guitar in, I just can't eat the bento lunch.
So you went bento?
Yeah. And then, man, that guitar was totally trashed.
It's on the side. So we cracked this whole piece all the way off. You can see the case was in there. This case can take 1,000 pounds of pressure.
I'll tell you.
So the
from the pictures, it looks like it was run over.
Yeah. Actually, it was probably dropped. What is this? Imagine the TSA did check it, but as it was going up the thing, it got stuck somehow on the ramp going into the plane, and then it fell straight like that, and it must have hit something on the edge that made it crack all the way down. Yeah, so
that's what happened.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure. You know, I wasn't there to see, but you know, my psychic mind is telling me this is what happened to my guitar. You know,
what kind of guitar was it?
This is Art Davis. It was custom made for me. Usually, these things cost about $20,000. This guy who built the guitar with me used to make guitars for Taylor Guitars in San Diego, and he chopped down the wood for the tree when he's only 10 years old with his great grandfather, who was a woodmaker. So he had this tree, it was called a Monterey spruce, sitting on his house. He had some pearls that came from Tahiti that he used for the inlay work. It had all of, you know, my amaku, which is the shark, had the taro leaf. You know, it's like an extended family. It had all this beautiful stuff. And here's these cracks with the screws popping in.
It's almost, it's like a friend.
Yeah, it's like a wife, you know.
Oh, yeah. So it hurts.
So it hurts, yeah. But, the thing is, you know, the airlines should look at this as like, this. God, come on, this is our livelihood. Musicians make their life. And then musicians bring life to the world. And they're also, it's like a common denominator. You know, there's so many wars and everything going on, but music is really there to bring peace to a lot of people. We're breaking down barriers here, you know. And you should be a little bit more careful. That's all. Yeah, thank you. Thanks for the opportunity to share. I can't mention the airline's names, but all I can say is, better not say. Thank you. Aloha.
Love it. Thank you, Mr. Pops. Hey, we heard there's some hula dances in the house, so if you like it, we got a stage back here. If you like it, go get up and dance some hula. And here's a song. A song written by one of our mentors, the great Bob Nelson, a song called Honeymoon. Any honeymoon dances? Come on, let's change. How about a hand for Ben Ho? Okay. When you see, come on, hula dances. Honole by moonlight, you'll be in heaven by the sea. Where's all these hula dances you go and talk about? She's taking off her shoes. Every wave will whisper, aloha, you're mine. Come up when you see a lay by moonlight. Open a hand.
Kahumoku, Kaapana, Ledward.
School of Dances right here in Minneapolis.
Yeah. Anyway, for many years we traveled with Dennis Kamakahi. This is one of his long, a song that he wrote about a fierce good woman, a song he wrote called Bahine Likia, comes from the island of Molokai. Any hula dancers know this one? Get up.
Yeah.
Gene, put you over there. Now you guys are in the street. Look at you, look at you.
We'll do a song that I wrote called Kahelani.
Giggles and you smile. Henny, henny, ko wa. Ko wa le a le a pa. Kami he ma ma o I ya. Ko yu me na. Henny, henny. Henny, henny, ko wa. Ko wa le a le a pa. Oh,
Go back to the island of Maui. I love going there, wherever I am. We'll go to a place where I spent a lot of time as a child, going to the very back side of the east side of the island, a place called Kipahulu, past Hana. If you've ever gone on that amazing windy road with all the waterfalls and all the valleys. I used to play soccer. It was a very popular thing growing up. And the Hana team was always undefeated, because all the kids from other parts of the island have to ride in the back of pickup trucks all the way out through that windy road and then try to play soccer afterwards. You could barely even stand up straight. Undefeated. And they had their own referees, so it was more like tackle soccer. But that's a beautiful part of the island where this song comes from, Kipahulu. We tune because we care.
Let's say we do because we fly. I don't know if I am. I'm full of back over there. Thank you. Stand if you're able, join hands and sing a song about a love boy. I want to thank you guys for joining us here at Dakota in cold Minnesota. Hana. Okay, this is rocker, Rocky Chair Hula. for the grandparents out there. All the things you can do in a rocking chair.
I see some hula out there.
Jeff, one more time.